It's a slight different Monday morning for me this morning. I'm down at Glasgow Airport, heading over to Norway with Scania, so that'll be quite exciting. First go to Heathrow and then on to Norway, so I'll keep you in the loop. Well, that's us landed, and also I've checked into the Radisson Blue Hotel, a lovely hotel here from Scandi, and we've got a hold of goodies in the bed waiting for us. Got a hat, hand warmers, gloves, great because I don't have any, a nice Scandi jacket, and a thermal mug to keep us warm tomorrow. We're going to go for some dinner, get to bed early, and then we're away up to ski resort tomorrow to drive some of these trucks. I'm so happy that Scania have invited us over here. I've always been a Scania girl and a V8 girl ever since I was a little. Scania has a massive place in my heart. When I first passed my license, I was in my dad's Scania six-wheel beaver tail, and it's a 2000 reg, so it's 23 years old now, and I can hand on my heart say that it's never ever let us down. We've never been off the road because it's broken down or anything. We also have a 143 V8 that we are restoring currently, and I cannot wait for it to get done because it's going to be an absolute beast. My partner Sandy, he also has Scania. He has some, drives them every single day, puts them to test on forest roads and hauling some not so nice loads, and I can say as well he's never had any real issues with the brand. Such reliable trucks. I'm so happy that we are getting noticed now through social media and different platforms, and get the opportunity to come out here and test drive the new trucks. There's something about getting to compare the old trucks to the new ones and seeing how things are moving forward for the future, and it's such a great opportunity. Morning, so last day, we're heading back up to this the trucks to get another couple, 2.5 hours I think we've got, test driving the ones that we didn't get yesterday. This is just leaving the Radisson Blue the now. There was a bit of snow overnight, so hopefully it won't be as slippy, a bit more traction, but we'll see. So how long have you worked with Scandi for?
I've been there for almost 31 years.
Wow!
So
a long time then.
Yeah, it's a long time.
Quite enjoy it?
Yeah. I started as a mechanic and I worked my up in the grades, and now I'm a technician.
Nice. Is my road positioning okay?
Yeah, it's good.
I'm used to driving on that side. Yeah, and the steering wheel on that side. I've never done it before. It looks a lot more slippery than yesterday.
They say it's not so slippery as it was yesterday.
Oh, really?
You see some places it's free of snow.
Yeah.
So it's,
so I'm out in the R590, there's a bit slippy up there, we've got a bit of a traffic jam going on. We seem to be moving now right enough, so I better jump back in. I just had a shot there on that R590 tipper with a trailer on it with the long drawbar. It's a huge drawbar on that, and the reason I went to have a shot of that was for the length and the drawbar. Back home we're never going to get the opportunity to drive something like that with the drawbar being that long. The reason they have a drawbar like that is so they can basically jackknife it, so they can tip the tipper and then the trailer as well. Very, very clever, and it was a very nice truck to drive. The one in front got stuck, they had to get down. I was in the middle, I got going no bother, and the one behind me got stuck also. So it's like, get off power! But it's all part of the fun. It's a bit carnage here just now with things getting stuck, it's so slippy, but it's all good fun. Next one I'm going to head for is a wrecker. Again, probably because I'll never get a chance to drive a wrecker, especially in the snow. So I'm going to give that a wee shot and see how it goes.
I saw that they had like an opening for a tow truck in Edinburgh, and I was like, I should go and see you!
Yeah.
Would you ever go?
You know what, it would be fun to try.
Yeah.
Just to see how they do things compared to us and see how their trucks are compared to us.
Back home they're like, most recovery trucks are like left hookers. Mm. So they're used to, it would bother you because you're used to driving on the left. I guess it'd just be like left and the right.
It would.
Now that's a wrap. What a time it's been, but now we're going to head back to get some lunch before heading to the airport and heading back home. It's going to be a bit slower going back to work tomorrow after playing these trucks for the last couple of days.
Well, thanks so much Scandi for that. Great trip, great opportunity. Probably never going to get the chance to do anything like this again. Had a great, from start to finish, everything. Flights, meals, company, like everything was great. Of course, driving the lorries was the highlight, but the whole experience was unreal. Thanks again.
Right, there was a change of plan when I came home. My dad phoned me and asked me if I'd go and look at a job quickly instead, because the guy's going to be back down to London tomorrow. So I know what it is, I've seen it before. It's just an extra, it's been changed a little bit, so it's just go to check it out again. It's a new water mains getting put in to a private house. I think it's something like 500 metres, so it's a good distance and a good job. So we'll go and meet the man here and see what he's saying to it. Bit of rushing about, but can't all be fun and games and playing in trucks and diggers and shows all the time.
And just like that, we are on Friday already. The week's probably flew past because I was away playing in trucks all week. But now back to reality, and I do need to get into the office this morning. I said yesterday that I would jump back on and let you know how I went with that job, but the reality was I went straight from looking at the job to pick my kids up from school, back to the house, get them dinner, and it was just chaos. So when I went and looked at that job yesterday, it was I looked back at the video, I said 500 metres, it was 1500 metres of water track and a few other bits and bobs they wanted done. A really good job, can do it in any weather, so that's the kind of stuff we're looking for. So that was good, but I'm back into the office, get some invoicing done and other stuff that I need to catch up on. So yeah, back in our wee office, it's nothing fancy because we don't like to spend any time in here. We just, the bare minimum of what we have to spend in here. I do all this kind of work for my dad's business, and I have done since I started with him. He can't send an email, he doesn't like any kind of interaction with the computer, although now he's obsessed with TikTok and Instagram. Maybe that's something to do with me. In my video last week, you would have seen HRM was out to give us a price on the Kubota. Things have moved very, very rapidly and we have bought a new machine. I don't think we're meant to do it as quick, but sometimes these things just fall into place. So I did pay for that yesterday and delivery will probably be next week or the week after now. Give us a comment below what you think we went for. There was a few discussions what it was going to be, but I'd like to see what you think we're going to go for, seeing as we do have so many different brands. That being said, we HRN are not buying our old Kubota off us. We got a better price elsewhere. So I'll get the invoice up and get that sent away, and then yeah, our old 57 will be gone. Which is a wee bit of a sad day because the 57-4 was the first brand new Kubota I was in. We had one previously before that one, exactly the same identical machines. But yeah, it'll be a sad day to see it go because they've never let us down in the 57-4. They are a really, really good machine. So yeah, I'll crack on and do a wee bit more of this, what nobody else wants to do, and I'll catch up in a wee bit. So that's my Friday done. It was a very boring Friday, but I had a very exciting start of the week, so it weighs itself up. It was honestly the most incredible experience. Don't think I'll get to do something like that ever again. To drive in them road conditions, them temperatures with lorries and trucks that I've never even sat in before, was really quite something else. When you're in them trucks, you're actually like gripping on, full concentration, but it was amazing. The whole Scania team, from the marketing, the directors, the boys, the demo boys and girls, everyone was just great. Such an amazing team, so fun. I just wish we could do it all again. So yeah, that summed it up pretty good. I will come back and do a Saturday and see what we're up to. I know we're going to be shipping some machines, so maybe put some content on that with Dad, try and get Dad on the camera, but I don't see it happening. Whenever he sees the camera, he just seems to laugh. Enjoy your Friday night, guys. I know I'm going to meet my friends, and yeah, see you tomorrow. Happy Saturday, everyone. I told you about doing something today. We're going to take the 57-4 into the dealer who we have sold it to. Dad's driving and I'm sitting passenger, so yeah, come with us. Well, that's us arrived here. I'm going to get this tipped and then that'll be it, gone. It's a sad day, let's go get this off of here. Well, that's us back after all the excitement of dropping off the boat of 57. We're back out to this old house in Cobelco here. The Cobelco will be getting shifted tomorrow to another job, so the plan's to knock down the rest of these big trees while me and Dad are both here. Probably can't see, but they are pretty close to the road down there, so one of us will just sit in the digger. Well, I'll sit in the digger and yeah, Dad will get them down with the chainsaw. That way they won't fall on the road. It's always nice getting to work on Saturday because it's not too, it's more chilled and more relaxed. We just kind of suit ourselves, but just make the most out of our time with the machine here, because God knows when we'll actually have a machine back at this house to get the rest done. Unfortunately, the pay jobs and work comes first. This is just a hobby as such. Well, that's our Saturday shift over. We'll be back at it tomorrow. Today I'm back in the Kubota. If you watched my video last week, you would have seen that I was up the hill road putting in offlets, letting potholes out, and we're going to refill. So today we've got hire off a tipper, a six-wheel tipper. Dad's loading flannings up at one end with the Cobelco. He'll load the tipper up and take it in, and we'll see how we go. I might, if there's only one or two potholes, I'll probably just scoop the flannings out the back and put it in. If there's a section that's bad, we'll overlay the whole section, and the further out we go, we've only got the tipper for today, so the further out we go, we might just put stockpiles where I can then run with the dumper. I know it's a bit of double handling materials, but sometimes you just have to do that to get the job done. We can't put it on the road because there's people coming in and out constantly as well. So yeah, we'll see how this goes. It's not nice as a day to do it, but it's the only day we can get a tipper, so it has to get done sometime. If we had to put jobs off with the weather we get in Scotland, literally no work we get done. Here comes the boss man now in the wee six-wheel tipper. Probably bounced his insides out coming down this road in it. So we've decided we're going to overlay all this section just because it's bad and there's no real ditch, we just cambered the road. So yeah, I'll put it on quite thick to get that camber to get the water off the road. Dad's not a professional tipper driver. Let's bear that in mind. We'll end up being a big pile here. 10 tonne here and 2 tonne over the rest. To be fair, tipper work is, it looks a lot easier than it actually is. Keep going! Look at that! That's got me first time luck! That is not bloody bad! Apart from a wee pile there. That was beginner's luck! That's the first load down and just finished, and he's hot on my back. Look at that. I see that's pretty bloody perfect. So that's my first load down. I'm pretty chuffed with that. It usually takes me about 40 minutes per 20 tonne. That's how I kind of work it out in my head. Sometimes it'll be quicker, sometimes it won't be. But with planings, I really, really do take my time because it's got to be perfect because cars and stuff are driving on it. We'll get a roller on this once it's all done and compact it all in. There's some, might be some bits we have to go back over if it's sunk down and whatever. 20 ton down, another 480 to go. It'll be a long day. Sometimes when it's not been dumped out how you want it, you do have to use the blade to spread it. It's the quickest way to spread it, but it just doesn't get the shape right. turn around, can see it's a lot better spread now, which makes it a lot easier to get the final shape with the tilty bucket on it.
So Dad's just going along here now and dumping a wee bundle at the worst potholes. I won't be able to scoop it out with this machine. It's a bit higher than the tipper's a bit higher than we thought it was going to be. So this is the next best way to do it. Hard to control right enough, but we'll get there.
That's Dad just arrived back now, and I was finished before him. He's now talking to one of the guys who lives up here. And this has popped up here 8 hours before maintenance. What this means is go and grease the rototill. It's always good having a wee reminder like that, to jump out and get my grease. So yeah, I'll go do that now while they do talk. So the grease gun I use is Nobody grease gun. It's called Fuchs, F-U-C-H-S. I prefer these ones over a battery one only because it's a wee machine. I don't have a million grease nipples to do. The rototill's only got 10. So doing that once a day, it's quite nice to get out the cab actually and stretch your legs. So yeah, I'm going to go and give these 10 nipples a grease and then get back in the cab because it's not very nice up here. Just like that, it's done. I've done the ones round about the hitch as well on the machine just because I was there. And I'll do the machine in another couple of days. I'm just waiting on my dad to come back, but I thought I'd run up the hill to show you this view. Locations, it's not just a good view we get. Look, all the wee hinds down from the hill. There's more there. Doesn't even bother Dippy do, he just looks at them. They'll probably eat out your hand. This is a camber that I like doing. One half downhill and one half towards the ditch. That should get the road lasting for a very long time. I'm all about camber, and I'll not say it enough. If you go on any road and it's wrecked with potholes, I could probably bet you that it's because it's flat. If you're looking at it, there's going to be no camber off it. That's why potholes are gathering there. See how perfect that is, if I do say so myself. On to the next bit. This is all done. We managed to get 7 loads in, which was a good number of loads. We just kept on going, didn't stop at all, and there was no traffic on the road, which obviously makes it a lot easier. And that sums my Sunday up and my week up. So I hope you enjoyed my crazy week. And remember to subscribe to come back next week and see what I'm up to. Thanks, guys. Perfect.